Hi folks, welcome to the Monday Marks Market Update. Today, I need to delve into the federal and local initiatives and stimulus packages to give you a really clear overview on what you might be eligible for. There's a lot to take in, so I'm gonna just breeze through it. And then if you're interested, send us an email and we'll write back to you with a really great overview document that's going to help you out in point form. So let's kick into it. The ACT government stimulus package. Now, this is all about initiative offering zero stamp duty for new properties, but you need to be an owner-occupier. That's the important thing there. It is, of course, for any buyer as well, and not just first home buyers, and it is not means tested. So that's a nice one. So this is going to be eligible for new land, where you'll end up building residential homes and off the plan apartments and townhouses. There is some criteria, however, and that is for properties up to $500,000, there is no stamp duty. However, between $500,000 and $750,000, there's a flat amount regardless of where it is in that range, and that's $11,400. Now, this concession is going to be in place until the 30th of June 2021. So the other initiative is the ACT First Home Buyers Concession. However, this also relates to people that haven't owned property for the last 2 years. So let's look at what this one entails. It's zero stamp duty on any property anywhere in the ACT at any price. The previous concession just offered that for new homes, whereas this, of course, can be for established as well. So a few criteria, you need to be over 18 years old. The gross income, this is an important criteria to be aware of, the gross income for the entire household, all family, for families, spouses, partners, everyone, must not exceed $160,000. If you have one dependent, that threshold goes up by $3,330 and keeps going up at that amount for every additional dependent. So this is a very big one here. You need to fit the income criteria. So all buyers, including partners, must not have owned property, any property at all, for the last 2 years. So just be aware of that. If, for example, you have a new partner and they have owned property within the last 2 years, you're not going to be eligible. And of course, you need to continuously live in the property within 12 months of ownership for 12 months afterwards. Now, the federal government stimulus, well, this is what you've been hearing about primarily relating to renovations, but also including new builds. To be eligible, you need to be an owner-occupier and an Australian, and you can get $25,000 go towards your new build or renovation. Again, some criteria. The renovations, well, they need to be in the range of $150,000 to $750,000. So you've got to spend your own money first, up to $150,000, to then get that $25,000 back. Important to note as well that the home being renovated must not have a current value prior to renovation exceeding $1.5 million. And so I've put that in there for people that are wealthy enough to not need this $25,000. If you're in a house north of 1.5 million, they're just trying to cut that criteria out for those people. Now, also the renovations are primarily there for internal works at a property. So they're not available to put a pool or a tennis court in, for example. So you do have to look at and get approved those types of renovations. And the grants, all these grants are going to be available until the 31st of December this year from the federal government. So not long to take advantage, go in and work out what you're doing and get that all locked away. So there's a lot to take in. Like I said, send us an email. We'll send it all to you. We're just trying to stay abreast of it, and we'll be reporting back to you everything we know as it comes in. Have a great day.